Funding covers for my tuition and my health insurance package, and the total amount was, I had a full funding actually, so it covers a total of I think over $40,000. Yeah. Oh.
To you. My name is Ms. Ankofua and this is the International Student Hub. Today, I welcome you to an educative session. So we have the opportunity to interact with an individual who has been able to secure funding in NAU. I know funding is really important to most of you who want to further your education. So today, I have the opportunity to interview none other but a special friend of mine. So without much ado, I would like to introduce to you Miss Doris Mensah, who is our guest for today. Doris, you're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for honoring our invitation as well.
Of course.
So I've already mentioned your name. Yeah. So yeah, just a quick one. She happens to be my roommate. So yeah. So where'd you come from, Miss Doris?
I'm a Ghanaian and I came from Ghana. I've lived in Takoradi and Tema all my life. Yeah, so.
Oh, okay. So we have a Takoradi baby.
Yeah.
Takoradi for you. Okay. And what university did you attend?
I went to University of Ghana, Legon.
Okay. Great. Yeah. One of the best institutions in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
And what program did you read?
I did political science and French. I combined the two.
So can you speak some French here?
Oui, bien sûr. Salut, je suis Doris. Je suis une étudiante internationale à Northern Arizona University aux États-Unis. Et aujourd'hui, j'ai un interview avec Miss Ankofua concernant comment on peut avoir ou bien comment on peut gagner une bourse pour améliorer votre éducation.
So, those of you who are lost, basically all that she said is today she has the opportunity to be here to share with you how to secure funding.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that is the agenda for today.
Yeah.
And I think we are on course. So then, how did you hear about Northern Arizona University?
Actually, I didn't know about NAU, frankly. It was a friend of mine who told me about NAU. Yeah, so that's how come I got to know about NAU. I got to know about NAU through a friend of mine.
Oh, okay, great. So, through recommendation, okay. Some of us, we had to go and also check. But for me, okay, I got to know about NAU because I have a few friends who also came through the institution and they recommended it. So then, coming to NAU, what were your expectations?
This is quite complicated because I had mixed feelings. It was during the era of the COVID-19, so even though I expected to have fun, to meet a couple of people, I knew there were going to be some changes in terms of how education was going to be enrolled and all that. So I expected to meet people, I mean people from different backgrounds and countries and mingle with them, but then I also knew that it was going to be quite different from the normal way we have our education because of the restrictions and how sessions have been now turned to online lectures and all that. So I was expecting much in terms of how to mingle with people, but I also expected that things would be different. So it's quite both sides. I expected things to go well and things to also be quite changed in terms of how the system will be run because of the pandemic.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, great. And yeah, so what program are you reading in NAU?
I'm doing politics and international affairs, a specialization in political science, more or less like a further program from what I started from my undergraduate program.
Okay. So then it is MS or MA?
It is MA Political Science with specialization in politics and international affairs.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So great. Wow. We have some political scientists or international relations person in the building. Okay. So then, when applying to NAU, did you make any research about funding? What did you get? Like, yeah.
Yes, I did research about funding, and I must say that there are times that I decided to not just stick to what was on the website because probably it hasn't been updated for a couple of years or something. So aside seeing on the site that they have funding or they give graduate assistantship to students, postgraduate students, I also went further to pick an email address from my department, any person at all, a lecturer or any international person, I mean, who is in charge of the international affairs for students. I picked up the email and I sent the person, I picked up the email address and I sent the person an email introducing myself and asking further if the department indeed gives funding to students. So I checked on the site and I also went further to get an email and sent to the person in my department to know much about it, because I didn't want to just rely on information on the website. I wanted confirmation of what I found. So yeah.
And guys, I think that is really the right thing to do. So it's very important to ask people, it's very important to also make your own research, but then you should always confirm with the department, because day in and day out things keep changing. Sometimes things may not be updated on the site like frequently. And I think getting in touch with maybe a person who actually is in the department, or maybe with the Center for International Student Education, really gives you a lot of information than what is provided. So you get up-to-date information, which is very key. And funding is very important, so you should always go the extra mile. You shouldn't just depend on what people tell you, oh, that may be my time, we did this, but then you should also dig and then make important research. So what Doris did is very, very great. So did you get funding at all?
Yes, I did get funding.
So how much is your funding? Like, how is it? Like, I know there are variations in the package. Yeah.
Okay, so my funding covers for my tuition and my health insurance package. And the total amount was, I had a full funding actually. So it covers a total of, I think, over $40,000. Yeah.
Okay. So then you have full funding, right?
Yes, I do.
And it covers your tuition and it covers your health insurance. I know.
Yeah.
And aside that, is it just the tuition? What else do you do? How do you get your stipend and all that?
Okay, so it comes with responsibilities. You don't just get funding and you come and do nothing. It comes with duties. So as a full-time graduate assistant, my funding is in such a way that I'm a graduate assistant. It's a graduate assistantship package. So I assist two faculty from my department, 10 hours each. So I work 20 hours per week. And as a result of that, I get my stipend at the end of every NAU pays bi-weekly. So after every 2 weeks, I get something. Look a few.
Okay, so then, yeah, I had to ask into details because we have variations in the funding. So some people get the full tuition waiver. So with that, it doesn't come with any stipend. Some people also get the 20 hours, like full funding with 20 hours GHF. So that is what Doris has. So they are paying for her school fees. And then most importantly, they are paying her health insurance. Yeah, health insurance package is very important here, because health insurance is quite expensive here. So if you have the 20 hours, then like, bars, my nigga, bars. And she's also a GA, that is a graduate assistant, yeah. So she works. Okay, so then how did you get your funding? Did you do any special thing? Why did they decide to give you 20 hours? What did you do for them?
How do I start this? Okay, so in applying to NAU, I had to indicate in my application forms or in the application process that I want to be, I think I ticked a section that stated graduate assistantship, yeah. So in applying, you have to fill out a portion that state that you want to be funded. So I did that, and also for my personal statement or my statement of purpose, I indicated in my statement of purpose that I want to be considered for funding for graduate assistantship specifically. So I did that, and also my application materials, I believe, were strong enough to warrant a graduate assistantship package. Yeah.
Okay, great. So then, yeah, so she has indicated that in her statement of purpose, she included that she would want to be funded. And then also, yeah, when you are applying to NAE, if I remember, there's a portal, and then in that portal, you have to fill some details and then attach some particulars, your transcript and others. And over there, they ask if you would want to be considered for funding, and then she stated that. So I think from the get-go, you should let them know that, yeah, you don't have, so you want to be supported. Okay, great. So then, did you have to go any extra mile? Did they require you to do something? I know for some schools, they will tell you that, okay, if you want to be considered for funding, you should apply before this date, or you should include something in your application, maybe GRE component or something.
Yes, for mine, I applied for the fall semester, so I was supposed to apply before December, before January, if I was to be considered for funding. So I applied, I think, in October. I also wrote GRE. So what I did was that when I was applying for the program for the school, my GRE certificate wasn't ready yet. So I just had to give them the figures that I had in my GRE score. And after it was ready, I also uploaded it. What you do is that after you write a GRE, you'll be required to send your results to the school, and you would have to know the code that your school has. So when you get to know the code that the school has, after your program, after your GRE score pops up, after you write the exam, you just select the school, and you should know the code that the school has. If you don't, it will go to a wrong school address. So you get to know the code that the school has, and then you select that code. So I did that, and then unfortunately, I was contacted, I think, after some weeks that the school has not received my GRE official score yet, even though I sent it to the school code after the exam was over. And I had to take a screenshot as evidence to the fact that I actually sent it to the school after my score came up. So that screenshot saved me, and they got to know that indeed I actually sent it to them after my score popped up. So when that happened, they were okay with it, and they got to know that, okay, so I've sent it to them already. And then I also had to attach an unofficial score or certificate to show that I wrote the GRE. So that's what I did, yeah.
Oh, okay. So the GRE, was it a requirement for your program admission or for funding?
Okay, it was not stated specifically that it was for funding, but it was a requirement for my program.
Okay, so guys, you have to check. Yeah, you have to check. For me, my program, I didn't write GRE. And yeah, so you have to check, and then also contact the faculty members. And do you think that liaison with the faculty members, that is writing back and forth, also sort of helps you in terms of funding?
Okay, so I would say that for me, yes, because it got to a point that there was a miscommunication. I think in my funding, one faculty contacted me and said that I didn't indicate that I want to be funded. So I was communicating with the person back and forth, and I made the person know that no, I indicated that I want to be funded in my application process. I indicated I want to be funded in my statement of purpose. So I don't know why suddenly this is coming up, because I made them know that I want to be funded. So she told me that it's not too late to be still considered for funding, so she's going to add my name to the list of students who are going to be considered for funding. So I actually followed up, because my admission came somewhere February or March. I had to follow up on the funding when I got my admission. I didn't want to just sit back and just know that, hey, the funding will come automatically. I followed up on the funding by mailing the department. And that's how I got to know that they said that I actually didn't indicate. Something that was very weird for me because I did indicate. So if I hadn't followed up, who knows? I might not have gotten the funding because they would have thought that I didn't want to be funded. So when I contacted them, I was now communicating with them back and forth, and then my name was added to the list of students who want to be funded. So after about a month, I think somewhere April, I got a mail that, hey, I'm considered for full funding. And that was like,
wow. Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
So yes, it's very important, guys. It's very, very important to constantly be in touch with the faculty or the department you have applied to. So it keeps your thoughts in their mind, or when they are making considering, they know that funding decisions, they know that, yeah, this girl is like, or this boy is serious, and then, yeah. So that is very important. So a key point I have picked from her statement is that, one, you should check the deadlines if you want to be funded. So for her program, if you needed to be funded, you should have applied or submitted your application before January, right?
Yeah.
Yes. And also stating in your statement of purpose, and also, yeah, stating in the application process that you want to be funded is also very important. So that is what basically she did, and then she has her funding. So then, Doris, what do you have to say to prospective applicants, those who would want to be considered for funding in the coming academic year?
Okay, so what I can see is that if you are considering coming to NAU and you love to be funded, it's a good opportunity actually, so you should seize it. And also be paying attention to the program requirements as well as the school requirements. Don't just think that every school has a general requirement or anything. Each school has what they prefer, and each program has what they look out for. So go to the department website, aside the school website, go to the department website and check out what your department wants or requires of you to do in terms of you applying for the program. And also be paying attention to deadlines and key details. If you have to pick up an email address from any faculty member and just mail the person, just do it and make sure that you have concrete details of what you are supposed to do, and that will really help you.
Yeah, that is really, really great. So guys, at the moment, let me say, those of you who would want to join in the fall, I think by now they are making the funding decisions already.
Yeah.
So if you've got admission, I think this is the time for you to follow up. Always express your gratitude, and you should always reply back when you receive an email. It's very important, because sometimes if you don't reply, you give them the impression that, oh, you're not interested in the program or, yeah, the process. So by now you would have received your admission, and I think it is the right time for you to follow up to know about funding. And hopefully we pray that everything works out well with you.
Yeah.
And yeah, so would you advise people to write GRE? Do you think GRE helped you come this far?
Well, that's a difficult question to answer. I would say, well, it could have helped, I think. Yeah, I'm sure it gave me an upper hand over those who didn't write. And I'm sure that it added up to my qualifications already in terms of my transcript and my class from my previous university. So I believe it was more like an icing on the cake. So if you want to write GRE, well, you can do so to maybe give you an upper hand over others, but then you should also think of whether your department really wants you to do it. But you can also do it as just more or less like an extra something to your
extra advantage.
Yeah, extra advantage that you have. Yeah. So, yeah.
Well, I think GRE is important too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, as she said, she's a first class student, so probably that alone did the job for her. But then her department required that she submitted GRE scores. So most important, we can't tell you that maybe for all the schools they are requiring GRE. You should do your research.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should do your research, especially department specific, because even though we are in the same school, I came in without GRE,
yeah,
but she had to write GRE. So you should, and this is one advice to you all trying to apply and come in. So because of the COVID, some schools have waived the GRE. So I think it is, let me say, an advantage for you if you don't want to write the GRE to seize the opportunity now. Because some schools, the deadline is till 2022. So for now, you can apply without the GRE. But once again, please do your research. I can't sit here and then generalize for all institutions and all departments. Okay, so then it's been a wonderful session. But then drawing the curtains, do you have any shout out to your family, friends, loved ones? What would you want to say?
So shout out to my mom, my dad, back home in Takoradi, to my sister, my brother. I love you all. Mwah.
Okay, that's wonderful. So I want to say that Doris, it's been great having you, and she would come back and then share her experience during the visa interview. I don't want to share mine with you because I had my visa, I took my visa interview outside Ghana, and then most of you watching us are from Ghana. I went for my visa interview in Belfast in the Northern Ireland, and I would say that it was very flexible, like most flexible interview I've ever attended. My visa interview lasted for just a minute, so I don't think it would really help you. So Doris was actually in Ghana during the pandemic and then attended her interview. So she's going to give us all the intricacies or the details you should know, because securing a visa is really important. You can get the school, you can get the funding, but visa can be a challenge to you. And on this note, we would want to say thank you again to Doris, and also say a special thank you to someone who is present here but you can't see her. So Macy is here, our camera woman. Shout out to you, Macy. Bless you for your time. And then to our viewers, thank you very much, and then stay tuned. If today is the first time you are watching us, don't forget to like, subscribe, and then share this video. We hope you have a lovely weekend.
Okay.
So what do we have to say? Adios.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.